now, Luke Casey continues his travels and takes another look into the Dale's diary.
Tim Lorry and the rock art of the Dales. And from rock, if you'll forgive the awful play on words, we turn now to jazz. Not the sort of music, I must confess, that one would normally associate with this part of the world. But one man has changed all that. By day, Ben Crosland is a barrister. But by night and at weekends, he's a jazz man, the leader of a group who uses his music to express a deep love of the hill country, particularly the remote area around Dent and Ribblesdale.
The interest in the Dales and music generally came together, really, when I was at school, not far from here at Sedbergh. A music master called Victor Brooke really inspired me to a love of music.
You went to school at Sedbergh, you say, but did you get much of a chance while you were there to explore the Dales?
Well, we had to go running a lot over them.
I know all about that. We once filmed the famous Wilson
yes,
Run.
Yes, that's right.
Did you ever do that one?
I did the 10-mile once, yes. It sticks in my mind.
It's not the kind of thing that I imagine would inspire a love of the Dales.
No, you only
if you're forced to do it.
If you've any sense, you only do it once. I remember, my father would come and collect me from school to take me out to breakfast. In my mind's eye, it was always sunshine. And driving from that 5 or 6 mile journey from Sedbergh into Dent, that was magical, really. And I like that very much indeed. And I suppose that cemented my feelings for the place.
Now, here's a chap who loves jazz, who loves the Dales, but decides to become a barrister.
Well, we've all got to have a day job, haven't we? I think there's always been a history of barristers perhaps having some interest in the arts. John Mortimer and, I suppose, Clive Anderson, if you view what he does art. So, yeah, I think I don't find a problem, certainly, between the two activities. I formed the band nearly 10 years ago, January 1990. We did our first gig at Wakefield Jazz Club. I'd been playing for several years. I really developed my practical side of my playing when I attended the Wavendon Summer Jazz Courses, which were started by John Dankworth and Cleo Lane in the early 80s. So I'd spent the 80s playing in various little groups, and I just decided that I wanted to form my own group. I'd always written music, and it seemed to be the right time.
I think you'll agree with me that jazz is not the sort of music one would immediately associate with the Dales, with the hill country, is it? You'd expect something perhaps more pastoral, I don't know.
Well, that may be right, but again, there are precedents for jazz composers using the jazz idiom to reflect their love of areas. There's a saxophone player called John Sermon who regularly writes music which has associations with Cornwall. And Stan Tracy, of course, wrote the Undermilt Wood Suite. So I don't think there's any subjects which are really couldn't be covered by jazz. It's just a musical idiom that is used, really.
So when you sit down and say to yourself, I'm going to write a piece of music that will be a tribute to this wonderful hill country, how do you start?
What I tried to do was to think of maybe four or five jumping off points for the music. I wrote a piece called Song of the Beck. Well, that had a certain waltz time connotation with the ebbing and flowing of the stream. So I wrote a piece called Song of the Beck, which is in waltz time. I wrote a piece dedicated to a friend of mine from school, Oliver Statham, who sadly died at a young age, and he's buried just down from here in the cemetery at Cowgill. And I tried to write a piece which perhaps reflected his passing.
The Ribblehead Viaduct was one of the inspirations.
That's right. Ribblehead Rattle was obviously the train association.
Why that?
Well, it just seemed a fun thing to do, really. To again, the train idea has always been something which has been embedded in the blues and in jazz, and it seemed maybe a nice thing to incorporate the two with the Ribblehead Viaduct, of course, and to write a sort of a train theme.
Being a barrister, the day job.
Yes.
Any chance of jazz becoming the day job?
I don't think so. It's a passion, and it will remain a passion, but I don't anticipate that I'll be able to do it full time.
And the Dales?
Oh, that will also remain a passion as well, yes, very much so.
Ben Crosland, celebrating the life of the Dales in jazz. And that, I'm afraid, brings us to the end of our wanderings for another week. We'll be back at the same time next week, but from me, for now, goodbye.
Stay with us for Beware Bad Drivers next on Yorkshire.